I am from the industry, rather than the academia and the research centers. I'm not talking about the gray water. In fact, I'm talking about what the water filter, the RO, and this reject water from the RO can be used for the to add the gray water. So basically, I'm adding the gray water rather than cleaning it as of now. That's my topic. Water is life. So 2.5% of the total water on the earth is fresh water. Contamination is a hidden crisis. It's basically the fluoride, arsenic, heavy metals, nitrate, pathogens, bacteria. Why I'm talking about why the RO is required. Groundwater is stressed. Highest rate of death due to the unsafe water is in India. The challenge. Do you know what is in your water? Mostly the people will not know what is there in the water, what they want to drink. So if they don't know, the best is go for the reverse osmosis. Why? It removes all bacteria, heavy metals, toxics, and improved taste. And that's why if you really see the market share of the RO is 50% worldwide, not only in India. Compared to the gravity-based where the water purifier started, goes to the UV and the RO. The flow diagram, basically because of the virtue of the technology, the RO do reject the water, people call it waste water, but it's not the waste, it's reject, because what it does, it purifies the water and the balance, the impurities, it goes to the reject. Can this be reused? That's another stuff which the people ask. The RO produces reject water due to technology. The quantum of reject water depends on membrane and TDS. The quality of the membrane and TDS in the raw water, this can be between 20 to 50%. Normal uses of water can in the residence is 10 to 15 liters. There's a lot of debate, like the RO is not good. It reject a lot of water. It's basically increase the salinity. So I'm coming out with that concept. And we translate the reject water as 40 to 60 liters at 20% rejection and 10 to 15 liters at 50% recovery. Normal TDS level in domestic application is between 1200 to 2000. At 2000 TDS, we expect the recovery would be 20%, and which amounts to under 92% the salt recovery, salt rejection. And at 1200 TDS, we expect the recovery would be 50%, with salt rejection at 97%. That's the mechanism of the membrane actually. With above the reject water, at 2000 TDS input water, it should be less than 60 liters at 2460 TDS. So if we are talking about 2000 TDS input water, the reject water is not more than 2500 TDS. So the concept the people think about that the TDS is very high in the reject, it's not true. In the domestic system, the TDS reject water is less than 2,500 TDS, which you do the calculation, it will always remain the same. The average gray water produced in four-member family between 400 to 500 liters. And the reject water from the RO is less than 5% if we mix it with the gray water. The reject water from RO when get diluted in the whole of gray water stream, the resultant increase in TDS is negligible, hardly to the tune of around 10 to 15 TDS. What else the reject water contains other than TDS? Hardness, heavy metals, bacteria, virus, VOCs, and toxics. What is the prevalent solution? The people talk about a lot of solutions to reuse the water, how to minimize the wastage from the RO. They say, do the car wash. Wash utensils, mopping floors, watering plant, cleaning clothes, toilet flushing. But what we are talking about is, are we taking care of the hardness, heavy metals, toxics? Everything which is present in the reject water, you're using it here. And also when you're touching with the hands, in fact, you are actually inviting some other diseases. So, what we propose, since most of the places, now the gray water segregation is happening, and it will increase day by day. So the reject water from the RO can be mixed with the grey water stream, and the TDS level of 2300 to 2500 of the reject water gets diluted to the negligible increase in the TDS of the grey water. And the hardness, heavy metals, bacteria, virus, VOCs, toxics, all can be taken care of by the grey water treatment. So we need not worry about the RO reject water, because many people feel today, a lot of debate is happening across the country, that the RO is not good. Because one of the reasons, it rejects, it wastes a lot of water. What my analysis or the WKE analysis is, that it's a simple, elegant, and practical solution. You don't need any separate container to reuse it. And it also avoids any chance of getting infection from bacterial and other harmful constituents present in the RO reject water. Grey water treatment saves 40% of the total household water uses. So our emphasis as an industry, as academia, as a government, that we should segregate the grey water stream and try to reuse it. There is a lot of technologies are available. People are talking about. As an industry, we also practice a lot of, if I have 1 minute, this is finished. So we talk about the MBR, wonderful technology, costly. But the cost will come down as soon as we start increasing more and more. Because that's the way the technology moves, the cost moves. If you increase your consumption, the industry will drive the cost low. Waste wetland. There are many technologies which are there. So I believe that put together, industry, academia, government, we can work out with a lot of solutions. Thank you.